Welcome to the SME 2-Minute Drill, where we cover a ThoughtSpot feature in 2 minutes or less. In this video, we're covering chart configurations and styling. The clock is running, so let's get started. So, in the 6.0 release of ThoughtSpot, you have the ability to add more customization options for your charts. So over here, you can change the chart type. Down here, you have the customization options, where if you go into the Y-axis, you have the ability to change the color of the line that's displayed. You can toggle back and forth between if you want to see data labels or not. You have the ability to take the category and change it from number to percentage or currency. You can change the units from no abbreviation to any one of these abbreviations. And you also have the ability to change the negative values representation. Now, from here, you also have the ability to slice with a color. This is useful if you want to add maybe like a category or a department color. And then down here in the settings, you have some more ways that you can configure your chart, where you can add grid lines, regression lines, or in the case of here where you have a lot of data, you can zoom into a specific selection. So over on the axes, you have the ability to do some things here. In this case, I have the ability for a time series for dates and time stamps to change the time bucket representation. I also have the ability to filter on this specific date, and you can sort from ascending or descending, or you can rename the axes. Over here, you have a few more options. You can change the aggregation. You can filter as well on this value. You can add conditional formatting to add lines to your chart. You can sort, and you can change the position from left or right. So if you'd like to follow along with our 2-minute drill, you can download this exact data set from our website at the link below. Until next time, this has been a SME 2-minute drill for ThoughtSpot.